Waikato te awa katohia, katohia he wai mau, katohia he wai mau, ka eke ki te pu aha o Waikato, te awa he piko he tanifa, he piko he tanifa ki atu, patora kei tahuri koe i ngā au, kaha o Waikato whakamau. Whakamau, tō titiro ki tā whitira kōtau, piri te maunga potatau, te tangata te mau, rio te motu e hoi tō waka ki ngā huahi aturanga wai wai, mō te ao katoa te tongi whakamutunga ama,
Everything I have been taught, done respects for the river, whether you're ill, you're sick, everything you do is pertaining to our river. And spirituality of the river is, to me, is our tupunas that have passed on before my time, and I respect our river in that sense. I was born beside the river.
I guess this is just another opportunity to make that relationship with the Waikato River. I guess look, we look at back into the tikanga of our ancestors. This was their highway. It's not ours anymore. We've got State Highway 1 and stuff like that. So this is about getting our tribe back onto the river, knowing the issues, knowing our tikanga, knowing our marae, and just really getting to know each other as well. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come.
If we can get all our kids through this and many people from our marais as possible, then everybody will then have a understanding of our awa and why it's so important that we've got the river settlement and you know how and what the tribe are doing to restore the river.
Listen, buddy winds up.
I'm learning myself of being down the hard road, and I've just found myself after 8 years, and this year will help me through with my journey as well. And I'm around positive people.
I'm from Hamilton, but I came over all the way from Perth in Australia to do the Tira Hoe this year. I'm hoping to get a good experience to find out where the Waikato River first started. I ended up watching the video from 2 years ago, and that made me want to do it, seeing everything. Rowing down the river is the main thing that I want to do this year. Yeah, I think it would just be a good accomplishment to be able to do that.
For me, it was to come and have to get an experience to be one with our tupuna awa as a kaitiaki. We want to have a look at all the issues pertaining to our awa, from the top to the bottom, the whole total issue that we got to deal with and look at. So for me, it's to get that environmental view and touch of our come on again with our awa.
Well, really, how important it is to the Māori people, as far as their cultural. Like it goes and spiritually, like I always knew it was, but just listening to a few kōrero, it's really hammered home how important it is and how close it is to them.
I think the most important thing for me is just the whakawhanaunatanga, so building the networks with the cousins across the tribal rohe, but also finding the connections with the other river iwi.
I don't believe that this stretch of the awa has seen a flotilla like this here with a large contingent of iwi Māori on it for more than 100 years.
I was born.
First of all, it's the first time, as Roger said, that our iwi has rowed along the Waikato down this way. And I'm the iwi girl, and I love being a part of the iwi, and it's a great privilege to even just hoi as a iwi together on the awa, especially here with Tainui as well.
I actually missed out 2 years ago, so I had to go to uni. But I was just keen on sort of most retracing the footsteps of our ancestors, the tupuna. So I just wanted to experience what they experienced and find out a bit more about our awa.
The experience of first paddling our own awa, and secondly to see the state that it's in. So it's it's been a bit of a, this part of the journey has been really good. It's been a really awesome experience.
Just for the experience, I heard through my cousin Taipa, he said that it was a hell of an experience, and you know, something that I'll never forget. And so far, it's been massive, and it's been unbelievable. I think just meeting everybody and actually rowing down the awa has been fantastic. Shine bright like a diamond.
Shine bright like a diamond. The significance for me for a start is that it's home. Hopefully, you know, our kids will see how important it is to get this place cleaned up. So it's the length of the river, it's the end of the Waikato, but it's the waiter that comes with it once they get here. These kids aren't the same, you know.
It was real good for me. It was emotional for me coming in as well too. Yeah, it's just taken me right back. Thinking of all my tupuna as well, what they did. But this year was the me and him experience for myself, and it was actually the meanings.
Well, I'll definitely remember everyone that I've met from the Tira Hoe this year. It's taught everyone how to like work as a team and everything, taught us how to communicate with each other. And yeah, I'd really come back next time to come to Te Puuaha again. It's a great experience. Shine bright like a diamond.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. So everyone knows each other's name now. Everyone knows what marae they're from. And I think, you know, they're going to go away knowing our tikanga, our wahi tapu, but also having that relationship. So years down the track, they'll, hey cuz, you know.
It was something special, mate. For me, coming home here to my home thing, there was something very touching, very spiritual.
Yeah, I'd encourage everybody, if you can get on it, you should get on it, because just get so much out of it. Learn heaps. And you know, I'm starting to cry. Because I think about my dad, he was on Waikatoa, and learning all the chants. Yeah, it was awesome, man, just looking across and everybody's doing the same thing. I'm really proud of myself, and I'm proud of everybody that paddled. You know, we had older men and women and rangatahi, and everybody was just focused there. Like a diamond, beautiful,
like diamonds in the... For them, I think it's the start of a longer journey. So, you know, I'm really happy for them. Really happy for the tribe, you know, it's about knowing about what our was about, so I think, yeah, I'm really happy with the outcome.
Yeah. koro mā. Tira hoe o Waikato. Tira hoe o Waikato.
Thanks to the river rats.
Thanks to the river rats.
Te tira hoe o Waikato.
Te tira hoe o Waikato.
Te hale hale ho.
Te hale hale ho.
We learned how to row.
We learned how to row.
From the surface cool air.
The surface cool air.
Underneath busy air.
Underneath busy air.
But importantly, I don't think you should see this as an end. This is actually a beginning. The beauty for you is that you can do this anytime you want. You got the awa in your backyard, it sits in the rohe, and you can go down and do this anytime you want. So think of this tira hoe as a beginning of your new relationship with the awa and getting back to that understanding and some of the work that we've been trying to do. So again, just give yourselves a big round of applause.
Waikato te awa katohia, katohia he wae mau. Katohia he wae mau, ka eke ki te pu aha o Waikato.